came to me some time ago when I went to a place called Periyakottai in Tamil Nadu. When I went for a preaching, that elderly mother came and told me, "Father, I thought God has blessed me with 3 lovely children. I educated all of them, 2 daughters, 1 son. And one day my son said, daughters are married and my children are coming up. Daddy is no more. Why do you keep all the property in your name? If you give it to me, I will use them. Make it money into business. I can use it for a greater purpose. Our properties, our gardens are simply lying. And all I have is you. Until the end of my breath, I will love you. Only after you, my wife or my children or anybody." The poor mother, I call her poor, though she had property, she did not understand the world. She did not understand. So she wrote everything on her son. After some time, hardly a month, a little quarrel happened between the mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. That's all. The son said, "See, mother, you have lived your life with the daddy." Very logical, he said. "You lived with the daddy. You had all fun. You had everything. And now, my wife has come into my life. I have to take care of her. And God has trusted and given me the children. I have to educate them. If you can adjust with my wife, stay. If you are not able to adjust, maybe you can spend some time with your daughters and go." When she went to the daughters, both the daughters said the same. "Mummy, haven't we born in your womb? Haven't you thought about at least 1 acre of land for us? How will we? Don't you know how we have to struggle with our husbands? They humiliated us. Look, your mother gave everything to your son, to your brother, and he gave nothing to you. She doesn't love you. She doesn't bother you. How can I convince my husband and children? If you are here, every day it will be a fight for me." The mother said, "No. I don't want you to fight. I don't want you to have pain. As a mother, I only wish always joy for you. Take care of yourself." She left them. By the grace of God, as she was crying in the church, one good Samaritan came and put her in an old age home. That home said, there are 2 varieties. Those who can pay little amount, they will have a cot. Those who don't have also can, but they have to work. So I am now 70 years old. Whatever I can do, I cut the vegetables. When everybody goes to the church, I have to sit in the kitchen and cut. My heart, I can hear some songs in the church. I pray to God with that. But I am happy because I have found my God. I have found my God. In the dark tunnel, there is light that never departs. That's what my husband used to tell me. Our life is like a dark tunnel, but the light will never depart. Don't just look at the darkness and lose sight of the light. Unless you focus, the light won't be seen to you. And that has become joy for me. Every day when I cut the vegetables, I pray, "Lord, what are the people going to have this meal? Bless all of them." Today my life has become a joy. Sometime the sister in charge of the home, she gets upset with me. She shouts at me because water is lying here and there. I'm not able to bend and clean that water, remove that water. She shouts at me, but I take it, Lord. Whatever my son, your son did sin, or my daughters have done, please forgive them. Please bless them. I'm happy that I am not with them, because of that I could pray for them. They have somebody to protect them. They have somebody who can pray 24 hours for them. What a great woman. Woman of faith. Woman of joy. And when she smiles, I can see all the 32 teeth of hers. It's full of joy. Yes. Many of the times we don't understand the world. We want to build up our life. We want to call us spiritual beings, but we want the world to build us. That is the dichotomy. Sometime the world may be with us. Sometime the world may not be with us. Sometime people may be with us. Sometime people may not be with us. Sometime we may get the things or what we desire from the world. Sometime we may not get. But our happiness depends not on that which is passing away, but that one who trusted me, loved me, and sent me into the world with a mission. Whomever he has given me, I will love them till the end. And I will never allow to take away the joy of God from me. My joy doesn't depend on what I get. My joy depends on what I am. So the more I talk to the Lord, Daddy, there are people who are with the things of the world and they struggle. Why did I get these children? There are some who don't have the things and don't have the children. They cry, why I have not received? This is the trick of the enemy, to bind us with what I get and what I don't get. But the joy comes in what I am in the Lord. What I am in the Lord. Yes. The moment we realize this truth, our life becomes a great freedom. Our mind becomes freedom. Today, man's mind is bound by the enemy. That's what we read in 2 Corinthians 4:4. God of this world blinds the mind of the people. How does it blind? It blinds with the things of this world, with the happenings of this world, with the issues of this world. And only when our mind is freed in the Lord, we begin to see our richness in the Lord, our glory in the Lord. That's why we read in Psalm 50, verse 15, whenever you are disturbed, whenever you lose sight of who you are in the Lord says, you have to keep your mind on the Lord. Only in the Lord you will be freed. When the Son of God frees you, you are free indeed, he said. That's why in Psalm 50, verse 15, the word of God says so beautifully. It says, then call on me in times of distress. The enemy will bring time of distress in your life. Distress means full of stress. Stress on what I don't have. Stress on what I have. Some are suffering. Why did I have this? What shall I do with this? Some people have their property. They don't know what to do with that. Who will take it away? Various type of stress, and that becomes distress. The stress comes because I don't have him. And because I don't have him, the enemy I have. When the absence of light, without my permission, darkness comes. So the moment in my stress, if I don't have him, the Lord, in my stress, I have the enemy with me. And the enemy with me makes use of the stress that comes on my way into a problem, into an agony, into a fight, into a distress, into a pain, into sickness. He turns into various things. That's why the Lord says, call upon me. In your moment of distress, when you think some kind of stress come on you, that is the time. That is the time you need to call upon him. Daddy, I am your child. Daddy, you loved me. When a father and mother, when they come together, as you know, there are so many millions of eggs are being produced. But God choose one, this egg and this egg, this X and Y chromosomes. He gathers and then makes a person. Yes, you are precious. You are chosen. You are chosen by God and sent by God.